Hi, I'm Avi Arditti from VOA Learning English with
Kate Woodsome
from VOA News, and we've been hosting one of VOA's international editions this week, and so we've been working together. And Kate has offered to join us here on a Skype call-in show, and we have on the line with us on Skype Özge from Istanbul, who is about to give us a video tour out her window in overlooking Istanbul. And Özge is a mechanical engineering student at a university there. So Özge, why don't you go ahead and point the camera out the window and describe for our listeners what you're seeing.
Well, it's the middle of the evening, so it's really hard to see what's outside. But in Istanbul, when you come here, you can see this very big bridge which connects two different lands, Asia and Europe. Mm-hmm. And it's a really fantastic view, you can see.
The Bosphorus, right? Is that the Bosphorus Strait, or I got my geography wrong? Where the two continents meet. What's that called, that spot?
Okay, I'm actually a little bit outside of Istanbul.
Okay.
It's not really the center of the city. It's a small town, and but you know, it's still crowded, and you can see so many people here too. It's not a village or something.
So tell us about your community. What kind of a sites are there? Let's say someone was going to come to Istanbul for a trip. What would you recommend they go see?
Well, there are a lot of churches and mosques and historical places, just like Hagia Sophia, Jami, and Sultanahmet, and some other places under the city. Mm-hmm. You can see interesting places, actually. Uh-huh. Really much.
So you're going to be starting school on Monday. This is university, this is college. Do you live at home with your family? Are you in a dormitory?
Well, I live with my family, and you can't just stay with the, you know, roommates or something. They have to choose you. You have to be chosen for that. Mm-hmm. So I have to go to school every day and come back to home. Mm-hmm. Well, it's actually my first year at college.
So exciting.
That's great. So how many years do you have ahead of you to get the degree? Are you going for a advanced degree, or what degree are you going for?
I'm going to be engineer after 4 years education, and actually 5 years, but I skipped a year. It's 1 year for English preparation, you know.
Uh-huh.
For English. I took an exam, proficiency exam, and I skipped it.
Oh, congratulations.
So it's going to be 4 years for me.
Your parents may appreciate that, right?
Well, they're actually used to it. They don't really appreciate it real much.
They just expect you to be extremely intelligent.
Yeah, it's a lot of pressure.
Yeah, I can imagine. Do you have brothers and sisters that are under the same pressure?
Yeah, my sister's an engineer too. She's a chemistry engineer. And my brother is a soldier.
Is, so he an, kinda... is he in active duty right now?
Not in a war.
Right.
He's working, yeah. He's an officer.
Okay.
Very nice. Well, Özge, thank you so much for calling us, and good luck with your college, and please keep us posted on you know, how your studies are going, and check back, okay?
Well, I'm really happy to talk to you, and thanks for accepting me.
Absolutely.
And I will be so grateful for that.
Okay. Well,
care.
Keep going to voaspecialenglish.com and tell your friends who aren't as good at English as you are that they can improve by going to our website. So,
Sure.
Okay.
Sure.
Take care.
Take care. Bye-bye. Bye.
So Kate, tell me a little bit about, tell our audience a little bit about your background as a reporter. Which countries have you traveled to?
I became very interested in reporting at a young age when I was in high school. I was pretty sure I wanted to be a journalist.
Mm-hmm.
So I joined the school newspaper, and then in college I was able to study and work in both Nicaragua and in Cuba.
Oh, okay.
So that was my first experience sort of doing research and writing overseas and starting to take in different cultures. And once I got a taste of that, I thought, I need to do this for a living. So after I graduated from college, I went to work at a small newspaper in Cambodia that was published in both English and Khmer. And I covered unions, labor unions. In Cambodia, garment factories, the garment industry is one of the biggest drivers of income
mm-hmm.
for the economy. And so labor unions have a very, they're very influential politically because they represent the garment workers that generate all the money for the economy. So.
And in fact, we have a call, or we did a moment ago, and let me see if we can get him back, from Cambodia. Maybe someone
great.
Who remembered you when you were
maybe
a VOA, reporting for VOA from there. Let's see. Hello, can you hear us?
Hello.
Hi. You're on with Avi and Kate.
Sok sabai, chumrep sua.
Hey.
Chumrep sua.
Chumrep sua.
I think that you can speak Khmer.
Tick tick.
Right.
Kanyambaniye tick tick.
Kate was just telling us about her background. She was a reporter for a while in Cambodia, covering the labor unions and
right.
And
I worked for the Cambodia Daily newspaper before VOA. Do you ever read that newspaper?
Sorry, it seems that I cannot catch up you clearly, huh? But I just know that you are working with VOA in Cambodia.
Yes, I was.
Great.
Are you living in Phnom Penh?
No, of course not. I've been living in Lebanon, working with United Nations here.
Okay, wow.
Yeah. I've been here more than 10 months already. Maybe another less than 3 months, maybe back in Cambodia.
Which UN force is that? I know that.
Cambodian.
The one in Lebanon that you're a part of. Which operation is that in Lebanon, for the UN?
Sorry, I'm not clear. The voice is not clear. So therefore, can you say again, please?
Yes. In Lebanon, what projects are you working on? For what UN
mission? What's the name of the UN mission that you're working
on? UNIFIL, United Nations. United Nations, yeah. United Nations Interim Force in Lebanon.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah, it's called UNIFIL.
It is so interesting that you're doing that because Cambodia had its own UN transitional
right.
force after its conflict. So it is very special that you're doing that in another country.
Sorry, I cannot hear you
okay.
clearly.
It's okay.
Can you call me again, please?
Let me try. I will try calling you right back. So here, let us try again. That was uncanny timing that we were
I know that was amazing
talking about Cambodia and we get a call.
That's great.
Hi.
Hello?
Is this any better? Can you hear us better?
Yeah, I think it's still the same biggest one. Can I try to call you back, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Sure.
Go ahead.
Yeah, okay.
Well, you saw the picture of him in his UN. I saw the blue hat and he's
and
oh, here we are.
He's standing on a snowy street in Lebanon, which is probably
hi.
Quite a difference from Cambodia.
How's this? Can you hear us now?
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, can you hear us?
Yeah, I heard you, but it's still not clear, but I try to understand you.
Okay.
Well, we were looking at your Skype photo where you're standing in snow and you're in uniform and you've got your blue hat on and there's a UN truck in the background. But what was, did you have experience in snow before in places where it snows? No?
Is Lebanon the first country where you have seen snow?
It's a big trouble, huh?
That's okay. Sorry that we're having difficulty.
I think, thank you for calling. We're going to go to Naheem, who's been calling us here at VOA Learning English on Skype. Let's see if Naheem, that's right, the Cambodian UN force was, it was before the elections or before, I remember.
It helped to set up and prepare the country for the elections.
For the election.
Yeah.
Naheem, is that you?
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, Naheem.
Can you speak
up? How are you?
Fine, thanks.
How are you?
Yeah, fine.
Where are you?
I'm from in India. I'm working for in Saudi Arabia.
Oh, wow.
So.
Hello?
Hi.
Yeah, Saudi Arabia.
What time is it in Saudi Arabia right now?
Maybe 10 p.m.
10 p.m. So what have you been doing?
I'm working for in web developer. Website developer.
For what?
Hello?
Website developer.
Okay.
I will.
What coding language do you use, or what do you have a particular software you particularly like, or?
In PHP, JavaScript, CSS, and everything.
How long have you been in Saudi Arabia?
Yeah, just only how in 1 year experience. Yeah.
What do you think? Are you comfortable? Do you have friends? Is it lonely?
There are a lot of other there are a lot of other foreign workers there, though, aren't there? Naheem, thank you for calling. We're going to go to a call from let's see if we can get this call here. Siam Bazi. I'm not sure I'm pronouncing your name right. Can you hear me? No. Okay. Then we're going to go to Nechi.
Nechailai.
Sometimes we don't always have luck with Myanmar.
Wow.
Yeah, it's always nice to get a caller from Burma, from Myanmar. We just had Aung San Suu Kyi.
Yeah, the Burmese opposition leader, now a member of parliament, was just at the Voice of America this week.
Kate, you followed her around
to
tweet.
I followed her around the building and told the Twittersphere what exactly she was doing, what she was wearing. She was in a beautiful red jacket. It's the power color. She had pink roses in her hair that were quite fresh. And a long skirt, and she was very gracious and patient with all the fans that were waiting to see her.
That was, and then the next day she got the congressional gold medal.
So she was here on sort of official and personal business, meeting with U.S. officials to talk about possibly ending U.S. sanctions. And then also to accept the U.S. Congress's highest award, which she received while under house arrest.
Right, she was awarded it and then couldn't come to accept it until now.
Yeah.
Okay, we are having a few problems because we've had a few calls. Let's try this fellow in Yemen. Let's see if we, Abdul Malik. Let's see if he will, because when we're talking to one person, it's hard when others are calling in and you can't take the other calls. You can't put them on hold on Skype. So let's see if we've... Oh, wait. Looks like we might have... Hello.
Oh, hi, Abdul.
Abdul Malik?
Yeah. How are you?
Fine, thanks. How
Welcome.
Are you?
You know, it's the first time I haven't expected that you're going to call me.
Oh, why not? where are you?
You know, I'm at home. You know, I'm not wearing my shirt.
Yeah,
just a minute.
We can see.
That's okay. You've got something on. That's okay.
Okay. Maybe you're gonna broadcast this.
Well, just your voice. So
it's
won't
okay.
be the video. Well, Abdul Malik.
Okay, it's.
What country are you calling from?
You know, my name is Abdul Malik.
Where do you live? What country?
I'm from Yemen.
Yemen. So
I live in Yemen, in Ab. Yemen, yeah.
How are
Yemen
things?
Yemen in Asia.
Of course, we very much in the news. How are things where you, in the part of Yemen where you live?
You know, nowadays Yemen is about to, you know, everything is gonna be alright. The new president is making reforms to the military forces and, you know, public offices. I think everything is gonna be okay. But, you know, after the political crisis, as some people say, and others say revolution, everything became upside down.
Mm-hmm.
Understand this? Understand me?
Absolutely, you sound very good. And when you say everything became upside down, for you personally, how was your life affected?
You know, my life at that time was perfect. You know why?
Why?
Because I had a job.
Oh, that's huge.
Sure.
Huge.
You know, I had a job, not an ordinary job, with the French organization.
Hmm.
What did you do? What kind of work?
You can say that we made programs to poor people, how to, you know, to help youth, to empower youth, to make, you know, small businesses, to aware uneducated women about, you know, health, about many things.
What do you
and,
do?
You know,
uh-huh.
especially in rural areas.
Uh-huh.
So then
I worked with them for a year. And after that, they didn't, you know, renew the contract with me because of the crisis, they said. So they left away and left me here, struggling with this life.
Hmm.
What do you have a job now?
And nowadays, you know, I'm studying accounting.
The world needs accountants, from what is, you know. I mean, every country has a need to. For people who can balance numbers and do accounting.
You know, I'm trying my best, though. I hate math.
I hate it, too.
You hate math?
I hate it, too. I like to write, I like to read, but math is so hard for me.
Wait a minute. So you're studying accounting, and you hate math?
Nowadays, you know, just you can say a three-month course, just, you know, in order to enable myself to have a better job.
So it's like a stepping stone.
Yeah,
yes,
that's what we say.
Yes,
it's a stepping stone to a better.
Yeah, you know, studying accounting, that's for accounting itself, but just, you know, a skill, to learn a skill.
Okay. So where are you studying that?
Nowadays.
Yeah.
I didn't catch it.
Where? Like at a school, or how are you studying accounting?
You know, I have finished my school 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
You can look at me. I'm 26.
26,
I can see you. You're 26.
Yeah. I'm 20. You know, I'm studying in an institute nowadays.
Uh-huh.
Good.
Well, maybe you'll discover you like accounting, or that you...
Well, I think it sounds like a very smart plan. Like, you've had an amazing experience with this French development group, which is fantastic, fantastic professional experience. And then if you add accounting, it's like you're strengthening your muscles, you know? So it seems like you're in a good process right now building. Exactly.
Well, Abdul Malik, we've got a call coming in, another call coming in, but thank you so much, and all the
best
to you, and please check back with us. We're going on now to Sarfraz. Are we pronouncing that right?
Hello?
Sarfraz.
I'm sorry, I'm trying to read it on the screen. Where are you calling from?
I am calling from Pakistan.
Pakistan.
Where in Pakistan?
I am in Sindh, Sarkar.
So where is that? Help me locate that in the country.
You listen the Karachi, name of Karachi?
Oh,
yes,
of course.
I know that.
I am also from this province.
Okay.
And I feel proud to speak with you.
Oh, well, we're
so happy to talk to you.
This is good.
Yes, yes. But your accent is very well.
Oh, thank you.
My accent is not good.
Your accent sounds great. Very,
yes.
Very
yeah,
good. It's fine.
No problem at all. What we've been reporting all day on events. This is Friday. It was a tumultuous day in a number of countries, including Pakistan. Where you are, were there protests where you were today?
Yes, I also prepare for the protest, and I also involved in the protest, and I am the what you say in English, Nara. I also the important person in this protest, because I speak against the voice of this Christian person who make this type of film. And I also heard from this type of film, because every person should respect to other religion.
Mm-hmm.
Don't make any type of thing for against the religion, because if a person who heard from the religion said, second person also heard.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. And so were the protests peaceful today? Like, how do you want to show your anger?
Our debater said to please peaceful protest. This is the preaching of Islam, that you should, if you feel that there is bad to you, but you should peaceful. You should unite and peaceful, and don't destroy any type of other religion persons. Only destroy a person who is the involved in type of this type of things, and don't destroy any type of other person, and don't destroy any un-Muslim person.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's interesting. Here in the United States, many Americans feel very uncomfortable, very sad about this video that has depicted the Prophet Muhammad in an offensive way. And we feel like it's not representative of our whole country. And I wonder if others in other countries where there are violent protests, they feel like that's not representative of them.
And the fact is, I mean, this, there've been a perception of that perhaps we have laws that could ban a video like this, but the fact is, historically, for over 200 years, the U.S. has had free First Amendment to the Constitution. It guarantees free speech, and it makes it very, very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
It creates a high bar to order anyone to. I mean, the government doesn't.
I mean, it's interesting. One of the reasons that many people think that the United States has positive values is because we have the opportunity to freely speak what we think. We're not censored, but that comes with good and bad.
I have a suggestion for your speaking. Please, on your video, not this time, after this time. And when you on your video and live, we watch you.
Mm-hmm.
When we will watch you, our interest will be grow when we watch you on live. And this is also growing my interest, but I feel very proud to talk with you.
Yeah.
I wait many time ago. I was waiting you many time ago for talk with you.
So Faraz, did you hear us on the radio? Did you know to call because we said it on the radio?
Did you hear us? Did you hear the news international edition, which we co-hosted today? Or did you just see that we were online on Skype right now?
Actually, dear, I was working in the outside of the Sakhar. I am electrical lineman in Sakhar region. And my duty is also depend the emergency duty. And my officer called me. I am going to there to emergency call.
Mm-hmm.
And I attend the complaint and so many other type of problem. That's why I haven't had time for VOA, and I listen many program of VOA at the YouTube.
Oh, nice.
Oh, okay.
Well,
cool.
I've heard it said that electricians are the smartest of the tradespeople because you work with electricity, and you make one mistake, you could die, obviously. So it requires a lot of intelligence to, especially you as a lineman, you're working with high power, right? High voltage lines.
Life taking working. If I not concentrate on my work, I will be dying.
Yeah.
May possible, 100%. And when I interest on my work and don't make any mistake, I will be alive. This is the life taking work. Oh yes, yes.
Well, keep paying attention to your work and to VOA. Thank you so much for calling.
Nice talking to you.
Thank you.
Okay, bye bye. All right, we're going to see. Let's see who we've gotten a couple of fresh contact requests. Let us go to.
So Avi right now is looking at the computer and the list of calls on Skype.
Oh, let's see. This person has tried 12 times to call, so let's try that.
They're persistent.
Persistent, yes. That's the thing with unlike...
Persistence is a good quality.
That's right. It is. Because eventually we will get to you. That's the thing with the, with the Skype. We can't put people on hold, so
we're looking at Asli Idil.
Let's see.
And my apologies if I didn't pronounce your name right.
Okay, here we go. Well, let's take this call. We've got
Sherzad.
Sherzad.
Hello.
Hey.
How are you?
Can
you turn your speaker down a little bit? We hear our voice coming back.
Sounds like
an
echo.
Let me turn on my
cam.
Do you hear me, sir?
Yes, we do.
Okay. I'm Sherzad from Afghanistan, Jalalabad City. Yeah.
How are you?
Fine. How are you doing, sir?
We're doing fine. Avi with Kate. And could you turn your computer speaker down a little bit, or your phone that you're on?
Okay.
Will you be able to hear us if you turn it down?
Oh, wait. We actually got a little video view for a moment there, but the... So it's just so we... Oh,
there
we are.
You are. Hey.
Yes. Yeah. But I cannot see you.
Oh.
It doesn't work when we're doing this in conjunction with Ustream, but we can see you, and tell us a little bit about what you do in, what kind of work do you do in Jalalabad City?
I am just working in a private school named Hill Model School and College in Jalalabad City.
Are you a teacher?
No, the manager of the principal of the school.
Oh, congratulations.
What kind of school is it? Tell us about it.
It's a private school registered with the government.
And so what kind of students attend the school?
There are different students from the nursery class up to 7. We have students in different classes, I mean.
And so help me understand how Afghanistan's school system works. Is it a privileged group that goes to private school?
Afghanistan has one system. It is from the Ministry of Education. It has it is up to 12th class. It is not a college system. It's up to 12th class. From the first class up to 12th class, the students are studying, and after class 12, they get graduate, and then they have an exam named Concours. If they are passed in Concours and passed to their in which university faculty they have chosen, then they will study that faculty 4 years. After that, they will get a bachelor degree.
And how much English does your school? How much English do your students learn? How many years of English?
How many years of English has Avi?
In the government schools, the English is started from the class 7.
Uh-huh.
But it is a our school is a private school. We tried to have it from class first.
Oh, from when they're very young.
First grade.
So like 6 years old or.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow, that's fantastic.
We accept the small students too for nursery and for classes, and they have study English too in that class. But they have to study only the alphabets and the sounds to be familiar with them, with it. Sorry.
Well, let me ask you a question, because we're always looking for ideas about how to reach, you know, young listeners and get them interested in learning English with VOA. What kinds of activities do the younger students like best for learning English?
Yeah, especially your programs are the best for the whole people, not only for the young people, the people who are trying to learn English, because the VOA special English is a best package for them. The people who are speaking in it, they have a clear voice, and they have they are pronouncing the words very nicely, and it's a really great package for everyone to learn from the VOA special English.
Oh my goodness, thank you. That's, we really appreciate that. I've been working for years in special English, and it's good to hear that a principal of a school in Afghanistan is the best testimonial. So thank you.
You're welcome, sir. Thanks for accepting me to have a nice chatting, calling with you. So.
Okay, Shahzad, we'll talk to you again soon. Thank
Take
you.
Care.
Bye-bye. Wow, that was nice.
Way to go.
That's way to go. Well, and the website, if you're interested in checking out Special English, voaspecialenglish.com. It's a daily news and information service. It's read at a slower speed, news and information for people at the upper beginner and intermediate level. Plus, we have other activities and games and more traditional English teaching in on our website also.
And there's also a Facebook page.
And there's a Facebook page, right. The VOA, the Learning English page, also on YouTube and on Facebook. We're on all the platforms. We try to... okay, we are on now with Stebet.
Okay, hi. Wait, my name is Stefan. Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you. Where are you calling from?
So I'm calling from Madagascar.
Oh, wow.
How are things, we have a very clear connection. How are things in Madagascar?
So things are really great here.
What's
it's 10.
At night?
It's 10:30 here, 10 at night.
And what city are you in, and what is it like there? I've honestly never spoken with someone from Madagascar. I'm excited.
Here's the first.
You're my first person to meet.
Are you from Antananarivo?
Okay. It's right here. It's a small, it's small. Madagascar is small highland.
Mm-hmm.
And what do you want to know about Madagascar?
Well, I what I remember was a few years ago talking to some English teachers at a conference. This was at a time of the political unrest, or that there were, you know, some political problems. I'm trying to remember the details, but have things, has the political situation settled? Has it calmed down in Madagascar?
Yeah. You're talking about the political unrest,
right?
If I'm not mistaken. Yeah. Yes, we are trying to solve the problem that we have now, but it's not yet solved.
Okay.
So we are trying to, to come to terms with what we went through a couple of years ago,
mm-hmm.
and
right.
people are trying to reconstruct their life.
And so for the audience that is not familiar with what happened in Madagascar, can you briefly explain
mm-hmm.
what happened a couple of years ago?
Couple of years ago, the depot's president wanted to take over the power.
Mm-hmm.
And the depot's president wanted to come back, and the new president said no way.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that was the case. I was not really into the political things, but what we went through was really hard.
How did it
but
affect
now,
you? How was it hard for you?
Did it affect you or your family personally?
Personally, it affected my job because I was working back then, so it was, you know, everything was disrupted. It was really hard, for example, to go to work, and that was almost what happened back then.
What kind of work were you doing?
There was a kind of problem solvers. I was providing some counseling services to troubled individuals.
Oh, wow. That's amazing. And so,
It was in French, but not in English.
That's so impressive. So were you working for an international group?
No, it was for a French company.
Okay.
For international group.
I'm thinking of a story we did not too long ago. I'm trying to remember if it was Madagascar or perhaps somewhere else. You have what are called sober houses there on the island or in Madagascar, for helping people with drug and alcohol dependency. It was a very it's a program that's gotten a lot of attention where the recovering addicts help themselves, basically. Are you familiar with that at all? I remember we did a story on that.
No, not really.
Okay.
But, you know, for the supportive, you know, to support those who are alcoholic.
Mm-hmm.
No, I was not really familiar with that.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Yeah, I'm so pleased to talk to you. I know Avi is as well, and I hope that the political situation steadies and becomes more stable so that you can start building a...
Good talking
yeah.
to you. We're going to go on now to Adnan. Let's see if we can bring Adnan in on the call here. Let's see. I guess it looks like he was trying to call us. Let's see if he is available. If not...
Oh, hello. Okay.
Adnan.
Hi, Adnan.
Hello, how are you?
Fine, thanks.
How are you?
I'm fine.
You're on live here on Skype with Kate Woodsome and Avi Arditti. Where are you calling from?
Sorry, what you said?
Where are you calling from, Adnan?
I am from Pakistan.
Oh, we just spoke with a gentleman from Pakistan. Where are you living? Which city?
Yeah, I have talked to you before. And I did call you before, and I share my problem with you about my accent.
Oh.
So I want to improve my accent. So what should I do? From where I should start? I haven't got any idea about that.
Frankly, I think you are. I can understand easily. I think Kate can too.
I mean,
everything you've said.
I don't know if your goal is to not have any accent and to speak like an American, but I think one thing that's beautiful about the world is that we can all speak English together, but we can sound different. And
mm-hmm.
you're very clear to me. What have you been doing to try to?
I want to ask, there is any material to improve accent?
I mean, there are, you know, various what they call like accent reduction programs. You could probably go online and find some. But again, I think clarity of understanding is probably more important than you know the idea of an accent. If people can understand what you're saying, then
yeah.
really that's the most
can
important
you-
thing.
Can you refer me to the person that is online or some material?
I mean, that's not something we really do. But Adnan, listen, good luck to you in your with English, and we're going to go on to someone from Jordan, who has been trying to reach us here. So we are. Let's see if.
And while we're waiting, Adnan, you can just keep speaking English, and as you get more comfortable with the
yeah.
language, I think that your accent will will become more comfortable with you. You'll just find your voice, and it's okay if it sounds different than mine.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know?
Really. It's okay.
So
let's
we're trying to call
we...
another caller.
Let's see here.
And while we're waiting, on the subject of accents, I come from a state in the northeast of the United States. It's called Maine. And my father has a really thick Maine accent.
So, like, give us an example.
So, for example, if he were to say the sentence, get in the car, he would say, get in the car. he would drop the R. And he's never going to change.
Uh-oh. Okay. Well, all right. Antonio. We're on the line here with Antonio. Can you hear us? Hello? Uh-oh. Antonio. I think we hear.
Antonio.
Are you there?
Yeah, yeah. I'm here.
Where is here? Where are you?
I'm fine. Yeah.
Okay. Well, what country?
Hi.
Okay. We hear children.
And Antonio has the picture on his Skype. He appears to be holding some sort of a skull.
It looks like
an animal skull.
You don't look like a cow skull or cattle, and you have some kind of meter with it. It's a very interesting Skype photo.
It's an intriguing photo that you have.
Can you hear us? Maybe not. Let's try again. Let's give him. This is. I want to talk to this guy. Anyone who stands with
him. What is going on in that photo?
He's got a great photo.
He has seemingly a bowl in one hand.
Or something.
A Geiger counter in another. I'm just kidding.
And a skull.
And a skull.
Antonio? Hello?
Yeah.
Hello, Antonio. Okay. All right. Well, I think...
Good to see your photo.
Okay. We are going to wrap this up for today. We've talked now. I'm looking at our list. We've had calls from an Iranian from Toronto. We had a young woman from Turkey, someone from Yemen, two from Pakistan, Afghanistan, Madagascar,
Fantastic.
This is fantastic. And Cambodia,
of course. Cambodia.
And you got to
talk
to someone from Cambodia where you reported. But we'll do this. I hope you'll come back soon.
Yeah,
this again.
Thanks to everyone for calling. It was such a pleasure to meet you. And I'm looking forward to meeting more of you.
And to learn English, go to voaspecialenglish.com or the VOA Learning English channel on YouTube. We're on Facebook, Twitter. We're our podcasts, Special English Podcasts on iTunes. We will talk to you again soon. Take care.
Take care.
Bye-bye.